In half an hour.
Coming up, a husband who thinks housework is purely for women.
I don't see why a man should do that sort of thing.
And a wife who does it all.
I cook and clean and iron and make his dinner. I would lay out his tile for him as he gets a shower.
And while it's clear some things have to change...
When God made woman, he did not think, I'll add an iron in the equation, OK?
Not everything is as it seems.
Can you be strong enough and strict enough to say, if you don't do it, there will be consequences? It's going to be difficult, but you realise it needs to be done.
A happy marriage needs heaps of hard work. And nobody knows that better than the woman who married this man. Yes, Angie Best is here on a mission to tackle marriages that need a little bit of magic put back into them. And Angie's not working alone. She's put together a top team of experts to help the brave couples who've invited us into their lives for a little marriage makeover. First, let's rewind to Monday, the 26th of June, 2006. Nelly Furtado was at number one with Man Eater. Belfast was playing host to the Special Olympics. But the big event for David and Sylvia was becoming Mr. and Mrs. Weatherup on the sun-drenched island of Cyprus.
Well, we always had talked about getting married anyhow. I suppose we were busy doing our things, you know.
We decided, you know, if we want to get married, why not do it in Cyprus? Go away and get married and make it really, really special.
This happy couple first met 10 years ago.
I rung her up to talk to her about selling this car, didn't I? Mm-hmm. And then I sort of said to her about going out on the Sunday night.
I had recognised him because he had a lovely car. He did catch my attention.
Both David and Sylvia had young daughters from previous relationships. They all set up home in Larne. 8 years and another daughter later, they decided to tie the knot. She smiled at me on
the subway. The thing worked out really well, because it was almost like we were a new couple, but all of a sudden, before we knew it, we were almost like a wee family. You're beautiful.
Fast forward 2 years. David, Sylvia, Lauren, Amy and Alex Louise are happily settled in Larne. Car mechanic David loves his wife.
I am particularly proud to have a wife like Sylvia. I mean, I couldn't fault her in any way.
Loves his children.
He puts my feelings and the girl's feelings before his own.
Loves his job.
Cars is my job, and I always love cars.
And loves German dance act Scooter.
All his music's brilliant, so it is. I really like it. It's just been a thing I have liked for years and years, this here, you know.
His van would be pumping loud as can be, boom, 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 boom. And that is why he would be slightly deaf as well.
Wife Sylvia, who also works full-time, does everything around the house.
I cook and clean and iron and make his dinner. I would lay out his tile for him as he gets a shower. I would put his clothes away for him, make his lunch.
Just about everything.
Well, just about.
And David sees no reason to help.
I don't see why a man should do that sort of thing.
Teenage daughters, Lauren and Amy, do little to lighten the load.
The washing's normally all done by her and the ironing's all done by her and everything's done by her.
Superwoman Sylvia seems happy doing everything for her family.
I just like to aim to please everybody and not, you know, provide. I like providing, keeping everybody happy.
But recently, she's noticed how little time she's had to herself.
But it is getting the stage now, whereas I would like to know how that feels to be able to sit there and they would come in and make the dinner and I put my feet up and just watch what's going on. I think that would be wonderful.
Answering the call from this week's couple, Angie's on hand to find out more about what makes their marriage tick.
So, David, when you look at Sylvia now, are you just the proudest man?
Truth be told, I'd sometimes wonder what she's doing with me. I think she could have done better. Not put myself down there, like, but she does look pretty good, I have to say. She's a lovely little girl. But I think maybe I may be a bit too rough and ready for her at times, like, you know.
Now, how romantic is David?
We wouldn't be just lovey-dovey like, as such as that. Maybe it's because we've got the kids now and, you know, we haven't got time to fuss around one another like that. It should be like that. It should be like that. But David would make a point of being very complimentary. He would come out with lovely comments. Occasionally, you know, he would come in with a favourite bar of chocolate of mine and a bottle of wine. And, you know, wee simple things like that there does a lot for me.
Romance doesn't seem to be an issue, but there is something that Sylvia's not too pleased about.
We gave up smoking for a whole year, and I think that was the most snoggable, kissable year we've had in our 10 years together. But then he took it back up again, and I think now he smokes more than ever, and because I know he can do it and he's given up a year, I would be on his case about it.
So smoking's an issue for Sylvia. But Angie wants to know if there's anything else. So she gets Sylvia on her own to find out more.
So it seems to me, my love, that you are a bit of a superwoman. You do everything. The job, the house, the kids, the husband. So it would benefit you if your husband did a little bit more around the house. That would make you happy?
Yes, that would be wonderful. That really would be. But I think to a certain degree, I still like to do things for him and the kids. But if you did that wee bit extra, coming in and cooking and cleaning up after him, that means that could free up my time to run a bath or spend more time with the girls.
Let's dig a little deeper and see how Sylvia marks David out of 10 in three different areas we've selected. First up, appearance.
About a 9. I think he actually would take more care about himself now than he would have when I initially met him, whereas before he didn't seem to care too much.
9. A high scoring start for David. Next up, around the house.
Maybe about a 5.
So still needs a little work.
Yeah.
A 5? Surely based on what we've seen, that score should be a little lower. Very generous. Next up, romance.
About an 8 or 9 at the moment. He's very considerate and very thoughtful.
No work to do in that category.
No, he's fine there.
A 9 for romance brings David's total to a respectable 23 out of 30. With a score that high, you'd be forgiven for wondering why Sylvia called us in the first place. It's going to be interesting to see what our expert-in-chief, David Kavanagh, makes of what Angie's learnt so far. David is a systemic family therapist. He's going to have to dig deep under the surface to uncover what's going on in this couple's relationship.
I had a really good time with this couple, David and Sylvia. Seriously though, this guy does nothing about the house, and neither do their two teenage daughters. Sylvia does everything, and she works full time.
Okay, I mean, it's common enough to have women working full time and doing all the housework, but a deeper concern of mine for this couple is that if David doesn't start doing more housework, then eventually Sylvia will just come to resent him, and that could destroy their marriage.
It's time to sit this week's couple down away from their home. In this neutral environment, our expert can get to the nitty-gritty of just what's going on in their marriage. He's concerned the lack of shared responsibility could lead to trouble in the future. Also, while David readily admits he lets Sylvia do everything around the house, our experts want to find out why Sylvia doesn't seem to mind.
So who does, what do you both work at? Do you both work?
Yeah.
So if you both work, why don't you both do the housework?
Yeah, well, this is the modern day age. I think still old habits still are there. You know, the wife is expected to do it all. And
who expects the wife to do
this? It's not that was worded wrongly. It's not that it's expected. I think it's a trend. You know, I watch my mother doing everything at home and my father went out. And it's maybe a trend from that I'm still want to be a bit like my mum, being able to provide for my husband and my kids and making the house comfortable and clean for him coming home. You know, and that's still, and I'm trying to balance work as well. So it's probably a lot to do with my own faults.
Interestingly, Sylvia seems to blame herself, not David, for the fact that she does too much around the house.
I've just met David and Sylvia, and he doesn't see any problem with Sylvia doing all the housework. Just watch this.
your kind of your housework routines. What actually happens?
Well, it's dead simple, Dave. She does it all, and I don't do none of it at all. I don't see why a man should do that sort of thing.
It's obvious we're going to have to tackle David's attitude towards housework, but our expert has deeper concerns. David needs to get through to this husband that housework should be shared, and it's not just woman's work. He also has to see if he can get the teenagers, Amy and Lauren, to lighten the load. Finally, David would try to get Sylvia to do less around the house. First step is to move Sylvia out of the house for a luxury two-day spa break, leaving David and the girls at the mercy of our team of experts. We'll reunite them in 2 days' time over a romantic meal that David has to prepare. It's day one. The first part of David's plan is to get Sylvia away from the house and all the work that goes with it. She'll spend the next few days relaxing.
Wow, exciting. This is going to be so quiet, so peaceful, absolutely amazing experience. I'm going to miss them loads, but I'm going to enjoy myself and make the most. This is just wonderful. Wow.
Back at the house, David, Amy and Lauren have no idea about the first part of David's plan for them. TA Captain Glenn Thomas has spent 25 years in the British Army. If anyone can get the people in the house working as a well-oiled machine, he can.
Oh, gosh. Right, Captain Glenn Thomas, you stand up.
Okay.
Don't laugh, girls. Get that cloth out. Top bathroom, lower bathroom, go. You find something funny? Do you find something funny, David? No, I think you do. Stand up. Stand up. Get straight out in the garden. We'll come back in here and start again. Out in the garden, go. Hurry up! Get out in the garden! Hurry up, big fella. We'll see who's laughing in a few minutes. Right down, not girly ones. Right down. Come on, right down. Right down. Come on, push it out. Right down. Get it down there. Get it down there. Right, get on your feet up. Up, quickly. Too slow. Back down. Give us another five, quick.
This might seem like an extreme measure, but that's exactly what David needs right now. He needs to have a fundamental shift in his thinking to understand that his role in the family is more about being the head of the house as opposed to letting his wife do all the housework. These children too need to get involved. Otherwise, they'll never learn independence and they'll never learn responsibility.
I'm led to believe that you think certain things are a bit girly. Uh-huh. Okay, things like ironing.
Yeah.
Things like washing up, cleaning a house. You think that's girly, yeah?
Yeah.
I have news for you, okay? 50 or 60,000 troops in the British Army. Everybody does it. I do it. Do I look girly?
No.
Do I look girly?
No.
Okay, and that wee smug grin that you keep having will be wiped off your face, okay? Because I don't find it funny. And I'm sure whilst your wife may smile at you because she pretends to find it funny, the fact that you're a lazy, good-for-nothing, idle person in this house when it comes to cleaning, okay, that in itself isn't funny. This is an ironing board, okay? Not a surfboard, an ironing board. Get the washing.
David's got the smile wiped off his face. And over at the hotel, Sylvia's kicking back in the spa.
I hope David is getting on okay, but I just can't help thinking that he might be panicking a little bit and stressing out, and I'm hoping he's enjoying the experience as much as I am.
Do the press-up! Don't mess me about! I'm a nice guy, but I've got a temper.
Back at the house, David's looking a little lost.
If you look there, it says 100% cotton, and there you see where it shows you the iron. That shows you that we can, in fact, use an iron. Now, if there was an X across that iron, that would mean that you can't iron it, okay?
Okay.
I think he was a bit slow on the uptake to begin with. Perhaps I scared him a wee bit.
Scared or not, he doesn't get time to hang around.
You want that seam at the bottom. That line there is going to be where we're going to put our crease in. Remember, two-hand operation, that's good. That's good use of the water. Big man, I tell you, we'll have you working on it. You'll have your own ironing business set up at the end of it.
You have no idea.
Captain Thomas pays a quick visit to the girls, and they don't look impressed.
Top tip when you're dusting down, always dust from the top down, because when you're dusting, dust is obviously going to fall. Right, I'm going to come back in half an hour and do a proper inspection. Hurry up and get it sorted out.
With all hands at full speed, the captain leaves this newly motivated family to it.
Once he realised that we weren't there to mess around, we were there to learn something, he got to grips with it and he's actually doing a good job.
At the hotel, Sylvia's been treated to a full body massage.
Get really used to this.
Time for part two of David's plan. Our expert has taken David to a well-known restaurant in Belfast.
Guys, this is David. He thinks that cooking is a woman's job.
Is it what?
A woman's job.
A woman's job?
We're sitting here and we'll show you what a woman's job is. Yeah?
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
David's thrown right into the deep end.
What are we doing here now? That's here. What happened today?
Bring the pepper, chef. Force the teapots and bring it to the
house. What I'm trying to show David in this situation is that real men work in kitchens. And that to work in his own kitchen will actually be something that's very good for him, and not something that makes him less of a man and makes him look like a woman.
So do you do any cooking at home at all?
No, not at all. I make pot noodles and that sort of thing down the game.
Like. Make a what?
Once they're fully blackened and starting to blister, move them across. Then we'll get the potatoes on.
Bit of a shock to the system, like. They were certainly busier than I thought, you know. What those guys were doing was probably as physically demanding as what I would do during the day. Totally came away with a different point of view there, I have to say.
Before he leaves, he's given one last woman's job.
Do the whole floor.
Over at the hotel, David's arrived to speak to Sylvia.
There are problems in the house, but it's not just David that has the problem. Sylvia too feels the need to overcompensate by doing all the housework. And that's a problem for her children, because her children are going to think that a woman's place is in the home doing all the housework. Your children are teenagers.
Yeah.
It's very important for teenagers to be involved in household chores. Why do you think I'm saying that to you? Why is that?
I realise it's to set the trend later on in their life so they're able to do it for themselves and make a home. But I just think lifestyle today is totally different, and maybe introducing it a wee bit later when they're 15, 16 is time enough. But I think I'm being told at the minute that it's not the right way at all, which is...
Yes, and I'm telling you that that's not actually the best approach, that young children need to be involved in housework, in household chores, because it gives them responsibility,
yeah.
It gives them maturity, and it also gives them a sense of self-esteem. Mm. Can you imagine why your children, your daughters, would feel a greater self-esteem if they were more involved in the household?
Yeah, they probably would feel really happy. They've made a real achievement and probably see their mum happy. And, I can see that now, yeah.
And if they refuse to do it, can you be strong enough and strict enough to say, if you don't do it, there will be consequences? You need to be much more in control and much more authoritative with your teenagers.
Okay.
For them to understand that this is actually what needs to happen in your household.
Mm-hmm. I have to turn my back to sad faces. That's going to be a challenge as well. I don't like to see sad faces in the house, but we'll give it a go.
What happens to you when you see sad faces?
It makes me sad. I just like everything to be happy and rosy all the time, you know, and see the kids really happy and bubbly, you know, but...
Is that realistic?
Probably not.
Probably?
It's not, actually.
Okay.
Yeah.
In a normal, healthy household, can you naturally expect everybody to be getting on all the time? Do you understand where I'm coming from with that?
I understand, but I'll have to get my head around it and adapt to that thought.
OK. It's going to be difficult, but
you
realise it needs to be done.
Yeah.
Back at the house, an expert David has left a letter for our husband and his girls.
All of Sylvia's housework must be completed by you and the girls by the end of the day. From now on, the three of you will do 50% of all daily chores around the house. As you already know Sylvia does everything, you must prepare a letter to her explaining why the situation needs to change. Best of luck in your challenge, Dave K.
David and the girls spend the rest of the evening cleaning and getting the house ready for Sylvia's return. The next morning, David takes some time out to reflect.
Up bright and early here. Didn't get all the ironing done last night. Going to do a bit this morning here. Having a lot of fun, I have to say here, though it's a steep learning curve for me.
Our expert has come to collect David's letter for Sylvia. But first, he has something he would like David to consider.
David, one of the things Sylvia has mentioned is how much she'd like to see you giving up cigarette smoking. Now, I don't expect you to give up smoking. Realistically speaking, it's not something you can do immediately or overnight. However, I do think it's important that you take her concern seriously. So what we've organised is for a psychotherapist like myself who specialises in hypnotherapy. He's going to try and work with you to help you give up cigarettes. Would that be okay with you?
Yeah, I'll give that a crack, see how we get on with it.
That was easy. A little too easy.
Can't promise anything, though.
Well, it's a start. David hands over his letter, which is taken immediately to Sylvia at the hotel.
Oh, to my lovely wife, Sylvia.
Oh! Wait,
to my lovely wife, Sylvia.
Sylvia.
Oh, bless.
How do we ring to it?
Wait, read it.
Okay. Just a wee letter from your new husband, Davey. Wow. I have to plan a new wedding and all now. I'm taking a break from my ironing to write you this letter to tell you that I was not the man you married. Very easy to become complacent around the house. However, I do promise to do my best to help you with more than the hoovering. Ironing is not as easy as it looks. The girls will also be showing a change. Hope you're having a lovely time at the spa. You deserve it. Got to go now and put some washing on. See you when you come home. Wow, lots of love, David.
Oh, sweetness.
So not only is he cooking, he's got to do the ironing as well.
And the washing.
Wow.
How do you feel about that?
The washing is something I really need to show him. I don't want him to get all the colours all mixed up. That would be a disaster.
Sylvia likes the letter, but immediately goes into housework mode. It might take a while for her to get used to the idea of her family helping out around the home. Back at the house, Kathy Martin has arrived. Our style guru has to find David the perfect outfit for tonight's reunion. She's asked him to try out some different looks to get a feel for the kind of clothes he's used to wearing.
Well, it's not a bad start, I suppose, but there are two main areas. The first is that he's not dressing very age appropriately. So is it the comfort thing?
Yeah,
or
I like
do you
the
actually
comfort.
Like the cut and the style?
I just like the style of it.
Do you not think you're maybe a wee bit past the hoodie stage at 38?
I probably am, like, but.
And the other thing is the colour, especially the yellow that's integrated. It's all messing up a little bit with his hair.
Kathy shoots off to find the perfect outfit for David. Meanwhile, Angie and Sylvia are working up a sweat over at the hotel.
So do you love working out?
I enjoy it. There's nothing beats it. Feels good. Just that feel-good factor and the vibes that you get afterwards.
Yep. That's your serotonin levels.
David's culinary skills are limited. Yes to boiling water for the odd ready meal. So, King of the Kitchen, Kevin Dundon, has arrived to lend a hand. This TV chef and successful hotel owner is going to show David how to prepare a dish which he'll have to lovingly recreate for Sylvia.
To me, the way to a woman's heart is true food. I think this is a great dish. I actually call this chicken done two ways. Watch your fingers, G.
I'm left-handed, Kevin.
Oh, is that what your problem is? There's loads of budding culinary enthusiasts out there and a bunch of guys. You just need to be pushed to get into the kitchen to actually do it. Because once you actually do it, yeah, it's very enjoyable.
While it's a straightforward recipe, there are some pitfalls.
The problem is with the dish, with the chicken dish, right? There's, you know, the butter underneath the skin has a tendency to burn. If it forgets about it on the other side, it could be a bit of a disaster.
But David looks like he's taking it all in his stride.
Okay.
David is a very nice guy, very eager, and I hope he pulls it off because it'd be super. It's hard enough to get a smile on your face enough of the time. This is a perfect way to do it.
Dish finished, and David's impressed.
Is there something to buy in a fancy restaurant?
So, best of luck.
I'll do that, okay. Kevin, the bar.
So enjoy.
All right.
Have a good one.
All right.
Yeah, thanks, mate. Bye.
Don't worry, David. You'll be fine. Probably. The countdown has begun. In just a few hours' time, this couple will be reunited. And over at the hotel, Sylvia's getting her hair and makeup taken care of by professionals. She's enjoyed herself.
It's just been really overwhelming. It's been fantastic.
But she does have some reservations.
I will be disappointed if there's no dinner when I go home, I have to say.
Before he starts dinner, Kathy drops off David's outfit. A simple, more age-appropriate combination. Jeans and a white shirt. Dinner's started, and David looks confident, but time is running out. Sylvia puts on her finishing touches and leaves for home.
I have really enjoyed the last 2 days. I've been really, really relaxing and absolute treat. Normally for me, it would be going to the hairdressers for a couple of hours. A couple of days has been absolute royalty. Fantastic to be lifted and laid and treated well. It'll be intriguing to see. I can't wait to go home to see what's been happening.
It's been a revealing 2 days for Sylvia and David. And it's all come to this. Angie and David must leave the couple alone, but they'll be watching the reunion from outside. If I lay here, if I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world? Forget what we're so lost.
Well, what do you think? Are you glad to be home?
Yes, I am very glad to be home. Glad to be home to a nice dinner.
You have yourself a morning.
Beautiful, it's lovely. Absolutely gorgeous.
Did you enjoy your time away?
I did. It was very relaxing. Mm-hmm. Really, really good. A real treat. And this is the icing on the cake.
As regards to smoking, I'm going to go and see a psychotherapist at the start of the week.
Get away.
Seriously. Can't promise nothing.
I really mean this.
I'm going to have a go and go to have a chat with the guy.
You have to do it for you. Don't do it for me. Do it for yourself.
I'll do it for myself. So we'll be around maybe for a few extra years to make you more dinners and stuff. I've had a lot of fun too. Plenty of ups and downs. Been very busy this last 2 days. Probably realised that there's actually get the chores done quickly so we can just spend a bit of time with each other.
Just the basics. Mm-hmm.
That's fantastic.
Oh.
That's the significance he needed to get.
Cheers, Dave. Right. Really okay. Proud of you.
Okay, thank you very much. Give us a kiss then.
A few weeks later, Andy and David drop in on the family, and the girls are full of news.
I've noticed that he's started to cook more, and it's a lot better than the normal, because it's usually burnt, and it's lovely, so it is.
He started, changing, and he stopped smoking as well, which is a good thing.
If I stay off cigarettes, Sylvia might even kiss me again.
I hope David keeps it all up, especially now he's given up the smoking, so to kick that out of the way and the cooking comes in and the ironing and all the rest of it is fantastic.
To reward him for his efforts, our team have organised a little surprise for David. A message from his musical heroes, German dance act, Scooter.
Hi David, I'm HB from Scooter, and I thought maybe I send you a message just to inspire you with my domesticity.
Dude, that's amazing.
I think maybe it's only to show your wife Sylvia that you would like to help her in a way. Always Hoover, wicked, easy now.
Isn't that really cool?
I got that.
That's awesome.
Imagine
David, you're speechless.
And David's not the only one who's been making an effort.
That I need to step back and not interfere, that is really, really hard. It's just so easy to take over, so that's something I have to work on.
Our marriage is going to be greatly improved, so it is. It's very easy to get yourself into a rut of things there. Sometimes you do need a bit of an MOT.
He's full of spark, enthusiasm, and it's really, really good to see that, you know. It's put a bit of youth into him. Love is all we got,
baby. Love is all we got. There, the parents. In half an hour. Coming up, a husband who thinks housework is purely for women.
I don't see why a man should do that sort of thing.
And a wife who does it all.
I cook and clean and iron and make his dinner. I would lay out his tile for him as he gets a shower.
And while it's clear some things have to change...
When God made woman, he did not think I'll add an iron in the equation, OK?
Not everything is as it seems.
Can you be strong enough and strict enough to say if you don't do it, there will be consequences? It's going to be difficult, but you realise it needs to be done.
A happy marriage needs heaps of hard work, and nobody knows that better than the woman who married this man. Yes, Angie Best is here on a mission to tackle marriages that need a little bit of magic put back into them. And Angie's not working alone. She's put together a top team of experts to help the brave couples who've invited us into their lives for a little marriage makeover. First, let's rewind to Monday, the 26th of June, 2006. Nelly Furtado was at number one with Man Eater. And Belfast was playing host to the Special Olympics. But the big event for David and Sylvia was becoming Mr. and Mrs. Weatherup on the sun-drenched island of Cyprus.
Well, we always had talked about getting married anyhow. Like, mm-hmm. I suppose we were busy doing our things, you know.
We decided, you know, if we're going to get married, why not do it in Cyprus? Go away and get married and make it really, really special.
This happy couple first met 10 years ago.
I rung her up to talk to her about selling this car, didn't I? Mm-hmm. And then I sort of said to her about going out on a Sunday night.
I had recognised him because he had a lovely car. He did catch my attention.
Both David and Sylvia had young daughters from previous relationships. They all set up home in Larne. 8 years and another daughter later, they decided to tie the knot. She smiled at me on
the subway. The thing worked out really well because it's almost like we were a new couple, but all of a sudden, before we knew it, we were almost like a wee family.
You're beautiful. Fast forward 2 years. David, Sylvia, Lauren, Amy, and Alex Louise are happily settled in Larne. Car mechanic David loves his wife.
I am particularly proud to have a wife like Sylvia. I mean, I couldn't fault her in any way.
Loves his children.
He puts my feelings and the girl's feelings before his own.
Loves his job.
Cars is my job, and I always love cars.
And loves German dance act Scooter.
All his music's brilliant, so it is. I really like it. It's just been a thing I have liked for years and years, this here, you know.
His van will be pumping loud as can be. Boom, 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 boom. And that is why he would be slightly deaf as well.
Wife Sylvia, who also works full-time, does everything around the house.
I cook and clean and iron and make his dinner. I would lay out his tile for him as he gets a shower. I would put his clothes away for him. Make his lunch.
It's just about everything, yeah. Just really.
Well, just about.
And David sees no reason to help.
I don't see why a man should do that sort of thing.
Teenage daughters, Lauren and Amy, do little to lighten the load.
The washing's normally all done by her and the ironing's all done by her and everything's done by her.
Superwoman Sylvia seems happy doing everything for her family.
I just like to aim to please everybody and not, you know, provide. I like providing, keeping everybody happy.
But recently, she's noticed how little time she's had to herself.
But it is getting the stage now, whereas I would like to know how that feels to be able to sit there and they would come in and make the dinner and I put my feet up and just watch what's going on. I think that would be wonderful.
Answering the call from this week's couple, Angie's on hand to find out more about what makes their marriage tick.
So, David, when you look at Sylvia now, are you just the proudest man?
Truth be told, I'd sometimes wonder what she's doing with me. I think she could have done better. Not put myself down there, like, but she does look pretty good, I have to say. She's a lovely little girl. But I think maybe a bit too rough and ready for her at times, like, you know.
Now, how romantic is David?
We wouldn't be just lovey-dovey like, as such as that. Maybe it's because we've got the kids now and, you know, we haven't got time to fuss around one another like that. It should be like that. But David would make a point of being very complimentary. He would come out with lovely comments. Occasionally, you know, he'll come in with a favourite bar of chocolate of mine and a bottle of wine and, you know, wee simple things like that there does a lot for me.
Romance doesn't seem to be an issue, but there is something that Sylvia's not too pleased about.
He gave up smoking for a whole year and I think that was the most snoggable, kissable year we've had in our 10 years together. But then he took it back up again and I think now he smokes more than ever, and because I know he can do it and he's given up a year, I would be on his case about it.
So smoking's an issue for Sylvia, but Angie wants to know if there's anything else. So she gets Sylvia on her own to find out more.
So it seems to me, my love, that you are a bit of a superwoman. You do everything, the job, the house, the kids, the husband. So it would benefit you if your husband did a little bit more around the house. That would make you happy?
Yes, that would be wonderful. It really would be. But I think to a certain degree, I still like to do things for him and the kids. But if you did that wee bit of extra coming in and cooking and cleaning up after him, that means that could free up my time to run a bath or spend more time with the girls.
Let's dig a little deeper and see how Sylvia marks David out of 10 in three different areas we've selected. First up, appearance.
About a 9. I think he actually would take more care about himself now than he would have when I initially met him, whereas before he didn't seem to care too much.
9. A high scoring start for David. Next up, around the house.
Maybe about a 5.
So still needs a little work.
Yeah.
A 5? Surely, based on what we've seen, that score should be a little lower. Very generous. Next up, romance.
About 8 or 9 at the moment. He's very considerate and very thoughtful.
No work to do in that category.
No, he's fine there.
A 9 for romance brings David's total to a respectable 23 out of 30. With a score that high, you'd be forgiven for wondering why Sylvia called us in the first place. It's going to be interesting to see what our expert-in-chief, David Kavanagh, makes of what Angie's learnt so far. David is a systemic family therapist. He's going to have to dig deep under the surface to uncover what's going on in this couple's relationship.
I had a really good time with this couple, David and Sylvia. Seriously though, this guy does nothing about the house, and neither do their two teenage daughters. Sylvia does everything, and she works full-time.
Okay, I mean, it's common enough to have women working full-time and doing all the housework, but a deeper concern of mine for this couple is that if David doesn't start doing more housework, then eventually Sylvia will just come to resent him, and that could destroy their marriage.
It's time to sit this week's couple down away from their home. In this neutral environment, our expert can get to the nitty-gritty of just what's going on in their marriage. He's concerned the lack of shared responsibility could lead to trouble in the future. Also, while David readily admits he lets Sylvia do everything around the house, our experts want to find out why Sylvia doesn't seem to mind.
So who does, what do you both work at? Do you both work?
Yeah.
So if you both work, why don't you both do the housework?
Yeah, well, this is the modern day age. I think still old habits still are there. You know, the wife is expected to do it all. And
who expects the wife to do
this? It's not that was worded wrongly. It's not that it's expected. I think it's a trend. You know, I watch my mother doing everything at home and my father when I, and it's maybe a trend from that I'm still want to be a bit like my mum, being able to provide for my husband and my kids and making the house comfortable and clean for him coming home. You know, and that's still, and I'm trying to balance work as well. So it's probably a lot to do with my own faults.
Interestingly, Sylvia seems to blame herself, not David, for the fact that she does too much around the house.
I've just met David and Sylvia, and he doesn't see any problem with Sylvia doing all the housework. Just watch this.
Your kind of your housework routines. What actually happens?
Well, it's dead simple, Dave. She does it all, and I don't do none of it at all. I don't see why a man should do that sort of thing.
It's obvious we're going to have to tackle David's attitude towards housework, but our expert has deeper concerns. David needs to get through to this husband that housework should be shared, and it's not just woman's work. He also has to see if he can get the teenagers, Amy and Lauren, to lighten the load. Finally, David would try to get Sylvia to do less around the house. First step is to move Sylvia out of the house for a luxury 2-day spa break, leaving David and the girls at the mercy of our team of experts. We'll reunite them in 2 days' time over a romantic meal that David has to prepare. It's day one. The first part of David's plan is to get Sylvia away from the house and all the work that goes with it. She'll spend the next few days relaxing.
Wow, exciting. Oh, it's amazing.
This is going to be so quiet, so peaceful, absolutely amazing experience. I'm going to miss them loads, but I'm going to enjoy myself and make the most. This is just wonderful. Wow.
Back at the house, David, Amy and Lauren have no idea about the first part of David's plan for them. TA Captain Glenn Thomas has spent 25 years in the British Army. If anyone can get the people in the house working as a well-oiled machine, he can.
Oh gosh. Right, Captain Glenn Thomas, you stand up.
Okay.
Don't laugh, girls. Get that cloth out. Top bathroom, lower bathroom, go. You find something funny? Do you find something funny, David? No, I think you do. Stand up. Stand up. Get straight out in the garden. We'll come back in here and start again. Out in the garden. Go. Hurry up! Get out in the garden! Hurry up, big fella. We'll see who's laughing in a few minutes. Right down. Not girly ones. Right down. Come on, right down. Right down. Come on, push it out. Right down. Get it down there. Get it down there. Right, get on your feet up. Up. Quickly. Too slow. Back down. Just another five. Quick.
This might seem like an extreme measure, but that's exactly what David needs right now. He needs to have a fundamental shift in his thinking to understand that his role in the family is more about being the head of the house as opposed to letting his wife do all the housework. These children too need to get involved, otherwise they'll never learn independence and they'll never learn responsibility.
I'm led to believe that you think certain things are a bit girly. Uh-huh. Okay, things like ironing.
Yeah.
Things like washing up, cleaning mm-hmm. a house. You think that's girly, yeah?
Yeah.
I've news for you, okay? 50 or 60,000 troops in the British Army, everybody does it. I do it. Do I look girly?
No.
Do I look girly?
No.
Okay, and that wee smug grin that you keep having will be wiped off your face, okay? Because I don't find it funny. And I'm sure whilst your wife may smile at you because she pretends to find it funny, the fact that you're a lazy, good-for-nothing, idle person in this house when it comes to cleaning, okay, that in itself isn't funny. This is an ironing board, okay? Not a surfboard, an ironing board. Get the washing...
David's got the smile wiped off his face. And over at the hotel, Sylvia's kicking back in the spa.
I hope David is getting on okay, but I just can't help thinking that he might be panicking a little bit and stressing out, and I'm hoping he's enjoying the experience as much as I am.
Do the press-up! Don't mess me about! I'm a nice guy, but I've got a temper.
Back at the house, David's looking a little lost.
If you look there, it says 100% cotton, and there you see where it shows you the iron. That shows you that we can, in fact, use an iron. Now, if there was an X across that iron, that would mean that you can't iron it, okay?
Okay.
I think it was a bit slow in the uptake to begin with. Perhaps I scared him a wee bit.
Scared or not, he doesn't get time to hang around.
You want that seam at the bottom. That line there is going to be where we're going to put our crease in. Number two hand operation, that's good. That's good use of the water. Big man, I tell you, we'll have you working on it. You'll have your own ironing business set up at the end of it.
You have no idea.
Captain Thomas pays a quick visit to the girls, and they don't look impressed.
Top tip when you're dusting down, always dust from the top down, because when you're dusting, dust is obviously going to fall. Right, I'm going to come back in half an hour and do a proper inspection. Hurry up and get it sorted out.
With all hands at full speed, the captain leaves this newly motivated family to it.
Once he realised that we weren't there to mess around, we were there to learn something, he got to grips with it and he's actually doing a good job.
At the hotel, Sylvia's been treated to a full body massage.
Really used to this.
Time for part two of David's plan. Our expert has taken David to a well-known restaurant in Belfast.
Guys, this is David. He thinks that cooking is a woman's job.
Is it what?
A woman's job.
A woman's job?
First in here, I'm gonna show you what a woman's job is, yeah?
One, two, three, four.
David's thrown right into the deep end.
What I'm trying to show David in this situation is that real men work in kitchens, and that to work in his own kitchen will actually be something that's very good for him, and not something that makes him less of a man and makes him look like a woman.
So do you do any cooking at home at all?
No, not at all. I make pot noodles and that sort of thing now and again. Like.
You make a what?
Once they're fully blackened and starting to blister, move them across. Then we'll get the potatoes on.
Bit of a shock to the system, like. They were certainly busier than I thought, you know. What those guys were doing was probably as physically demanding as what I would do during the day. totally came away with a different point of view there, I have to say.
Before he leaves, he's given one last woman's job.
Do the whole floor.
Over at the hotel, David's arrived to speak to Sylvia.
There are problems in the house, but it's not just David that has the problem. Sylvia too feels the need to overcompensate by doing all the housework. And that's a problem for her children, because her children are going to think that a woman's place is in the home doing all the housework. Your children are teenagers.
Yeah.
It's very important for teenagers to be involved in household chores. Why do you think I'm saying that to you? Why is that?
I realise it's to set the trend later on in their life so they're able to do it for themselves and make a home. But I just think lifestyle today is totally different, and maybe introducing it a wee bit later when they're 15, 16 is time enough. But I think I'm being told at the minute that it's not the right way at all, which is...
Yes, and I'm telling you that that's not actually the best approach, that young children need to be involved in housework, in household chores, because it gives them responsibility,
yeah.
It gives them maturity, and it also gives them a sense of self-esteem. Mm. Can you imagine why your children, your daughters, would feel a greater self-esteem if they were more involved in the household?
Yeah, they probably would feel really happy. They've made a real achievement and probably see their mum happy. And, I can see that now, yeah.
And if they refuse to do it, can you be strong enough and strict enough to say, if you don't do it, there will be consequences? You need to be much more in control and much more authoritative with your teenagers.
Okay.
For them to understand that this is actually what needs to happen in your household.
I have to turn my back to sad faces. That's going to be a challenge as well. I don't like to see sad faces in the house, but we'll give it a go.
What happens to you when you see sad faces?
It makes me sad. I just like everything to be happy and rosy all the time, you know, and see the kids really happy and bubbly, you know, but...
Is that realistic?
Probably not.
Probably?
It's not, actually.
Okay.
Yeah.
In a normal, healthy household, can you naturally expect everybody to be getting on all the time? Do you understand where I'm coming from with that?
I understand, but I'll have to get my head around it and adapt to that thought.
Okay. It's going to be difficult, but
you
realise it needs to be done.
Yeah.
Back at the house, an expert David has left a letter for our husband and his girls.
All of Sylvia's housework must be completed by you and the girls by the end of the day. From now on, the three of you will do 50% of all daily chores around the house. As you already know Sylvia does everything, you must prepare a letter to her explaining why the situation needs to change. Best of luck in your challenge, Dave K.
David and the girls spend the rest of the evening cleaning and getting the house ready for Sylvia's return. The next morning, David takes some time out to reflect.
Up bright and early here. Didn't get all the ironing done last night. Going to do a bit this morning here. Having a lot of fun, I have to say here, though it's a steep learning curve for me.
Our expert has come to collect David's letter for Sylvia. But first, he has something he would like David to consider.
David, one of the things Sylvia has mentioned is how much she'd like to see you giving up cigarette smoking. Now, I don't expect you to give up smoking. Realistically speaking, it's not something you can do immediately or overnight. However, I do think it's important that you take her concern seriously. So what we've organised is for a psychotherapist like myself who specialises in hypnotherapy, he's going to try and work with you to help you give up cigarettes. Would that be okay with you?
Yeah, I'll give that a crack, see how we get on with it.
That was easy. A little too easy.
Can't promise anything, though.
Well, it's a start. David hands over his letter, which is taken immediately to Sylvia at the hotel.
Oh, to my lovely wife, Sylvia.
Oh! Wait, to my lovely wife, Sylvia.
Oh, bless.
How
do we ring to it?
Wait, read it.
Okay. Just a wee letter from your new husband, Davy. Wow. I have to plan a new wedding and all now. I'm taking a break from my ironing to write you this letter to tell you that I was not the man you married. Very easy to become complacent around the house. However, I do promise to do my best to help you with more than the hoovering. Ironing is not as easy as it looks. The girls will also be showing a change. Hope you're having a lovely time at the spa. You deserve it. Got to go now and put some washing on. See you when you come home. Wow, lots of love, David.
Oh, sweetness.
So not only is he cooking, he's got to do the ironing as well.
And the washing.
Wow.
How do you feel about that?
The washing is something I really need to show him. I don't want him to get all the colours and all mixed up. That would be a disaster.
Sylvia likes the letter, but immediately goes into housework mode. It might take a while for her to get used to the idea of her family helping out around the home. Back at the house, Kathy Martin has arrived. Our style guru has to find David the perfect outfit for tonight's reunion. She's asked him to try out some different looks to get a feel for the kind of clothes he's used to wearing.
Well, it's not a bad start, I suppose, but there are two main areas. The first is that he's not dressing very age appropriately. So is it the comfort thing?
Yeah,
or do
I like
you actually
comfort.
Like the cut and the style?
I just like the style of it.
Do you not think you're maybe a wee bit past the hoodie stage at 38?
I probably am, like, but...
And the other thing is the colour, especially the yellow that's integrated. It's all messing up a little bit with his hair.
Kathy shoots off to find the perfect outfit for David. Meanwhile, Angie and Sylvia are working up a sweat over at the hotel.
So do you love working out?
I enjoy it. There's nothing beats it. Feels good. Just that feel-good factor and the vibes that you get afterwards.
Yep. That's your serotonin levels.
David's culinary skills are... limited. Yes to boiling water for the odd ready meal. So, King of the Kitchen, Kevin Dundon has arrived to lend a hand. This TV chef and successful hotel owner is going to show David how to prepare a dish which he'll have to lovingly recreate for Sylvia.
To me, the way through a woman's heart is true food. I think this is a great dish. I actually call this chicken done two ways. Watch your fingers, G.
I'm left-handed, Kevin.
Oh, is that what your problem is? There's loads of budding culinary enthusiasts out there in a bunch of guys. You just need to be pushed to get into the kitchen to actually do it. Because once you actually do it, yeah, it's very enjoyable.
While it's a straightforward recipe, there are some pitfalls.
The problem is with the dish, with the chicken dish, right? There's, you know, the butter underneath the skin, has a tendency to burn. If it forgets about it on the other side, could be a bit of a disaster.
But David looks like he's taking it all in his stride.
Okay.
David is a very nice guy, very eager, and I hope he pulls it off because it'd be super. It's hard enough to get a smile on your wife's face enough of the time. This is the perfect way to do it.
Dish finished, and David's impressed.
Is there something to buy in a fancy restaurant?
So, best of luck.
I'll do that, okay. Kevin, the bar, bye.
Enjoy.
All right,
have a good one.
All right,
yeah,
thanks,
mate.
Bye-bye.
Don't worry, David, you'll be fine. Probably. The countdown has begun. In just a few hours' time, this couple will be reunited. And over at the hotel, Sylvia's getting her hair and makeup taken care of by professionals. She's enjoyed herself.
It's just been really overwhelming. It's been fantastic.
But she does have some reservations.
I will be disappointed if there's no dinner when I go home, I have to say.
Before he starts dinner, Kathy drops off David's outfit. A simple, more age-appropriate combination. Jeans and a white shirt. Dinner's started, and David looks confident, but time is running out. Sylvia puts on her finishing touches and leaves for home.
I have really enjoyed the last 2 days. They've been really, really relaxing and absolute treat. Normally for me, it would be going to the hairdressers for a couple of hours. A couple of days has been absolute royalty. Fantastic to be lifted and laid and treated well. It'll be intriguing to see. I can't wait to go home to see what's been happening.
It's been a revealing 2 days for Sylvia and David. And it's all come to this. Angie and David must leave the couple alone, but they'll be watching the reunion from outside.
Yeah.
Well, what do you think? Are you glad to be home?
Yes, I am very glad to be home. Glad to be home to a nice dinner.
You're here some morning.
Beautiful. It's lovely. Absolutely gorgeous.
Did you enjoy your time away?
I did. It was very relaxing. Mm-hmm. Really, really good. A real treat. And this is the icing on the cake.
As regards to smoking, I'm going to go and see a psychotherapist at the start of the week.
Get away.
Seriously. Can't promise nothing.
Really
like,
mean
I'm going to have a go and go and have a chat with the guy.
You have to do it for you, don't do it for me, do it for yourself.
I'll do it for myself, so I'll be around maybe for a few extra years to make you more dinners and stuff. I've had a lot of fun too. Plenty of ups and downs, been very busy this last 2 days. Probably realised there's actually get the chores done quickly so we can just spend a bit of time with each other.
Just the basics. Mm-hmm.
That's fantastic.
Oh.
That's the significance he needed to get.
Cheers, well done, Deva. Really okay. Proud of you.
Okay, thank you very much. Give us a kiss then.
A few weeks later, Andy and David drop in on the family, and the girls are full of news.
I've noticed that he's started to kick more, and it's a lot better than the normal, because it's usually burnt, and it's lovely, so it is.
He started like changing and he stopped smoking as well, which is a good thing.
If I stay off cigarettes, Sylvia might even kiss me again.
I hope Deva keeps it all up, especially now he's given up the smoking, so to kick that out of the way and the cooking comes in and the ironing and all the rest of it is fantastic.
To reward him for his efforts, our team have organised a little surprise for David. A message from his musical heroes, German dance act, Scooter.
Hi David, I'm HB from Scooter, and I thought maybe I send you a message just to inspire you with my domesticity.
Indeed. That's amazing.
I think maybe it's only to show your wife Sylvia that you would like to help her in a way. Always Hoover, wicked, easy now.
It's not really cool.
Cool. Cool. That's
awesome. You got
to go.
Jimmy, you're speechless.
And David's not the only one who's been making an effort.
But I need to step back and not interfere. That is really, really hard. It's just so easy to take over. So that's something I have to work on.
Our marriage is going to be greatly improved. So it is. It's very easy to get yourself into a rut of things there. Sometimes you do need a bit of an MOT.
It's just, he's full of spark, enthusiasm, and it's really, really good to see that, you know. It's put a bit of youth into him. Love is all we got,
baby. Love is all we got. There, the parents.